less than a mile away from the high street, and I'm on this extremely pleasant and popular residential road. It's full of really rather substantial Victorian houses, and it's this one I'm here to see. Now, it's got three bedrooms and had a guide price of £120,000 to £130,000. Wow, untouched or what? It's quite rare that you see houses like this. My goodness, just the way they've been decorated. And look, you've got crystal windows in here. Hello, incredible. I'm just wondering if it'll be worth taking this whole middle section out and opening these two rooms up. But look at the cornicing in here. You see, I know I'm getting incredibly excited, and most of you looking at this will think, what? It's like a film set. So much work needs to take place in here. And I know this would frighten a lot of you off. Look at this old boiler. But the thing I love about it is that it is untouched. You've got beautiful doors, lovely big open spaces. I mean, look at this for a kitchen. Is it scary or is it really exciting? I don't know. I'm going to investigate further. Well, the space continues upstairs. I mean, look at the proportions of this room. Fantastic. And, yup, good news, there is a garden. Bad news, it's completely overgrown. I can't even see where it ends. There's just brambles and bushes everywhere. And if you like blackberries, you're in luck.
Well, the Garden of England, it is not. There might just be a bit of outside space lurking under all that foliage. Back inside, the next stop is the only bathroom, which is a touch on the small side, really. There's a second bedroom, and at the front of the house, the crowning glory.
So the master bedroom, as you'd expect, in a lovely untouched Victorian house like this. I mean, just a gorgeous window area. Really, truly fantastic. But I am wondering, can you squeeze in an ensuite or a bathroom? Because at the moment, you've just got one family bathroom. There is something you could do, and I've seen it done many times before, and it does work really well. Just put a wall up here. You could have an independent space in here because you've got your window. So you could still keep the nice proportions of this room. Bedroom, bathroom, and I think that would really add value to this property.
At £190,000 bid I have for the first time, £190,000 bid for the second time, third and final bid at £190,000, we're all done. Yours at £190,000, sir, and your number, please.
And that successful bid of £190,000 came from Maidstone local Colin. I met Colin and his builder, Andrew, for a quick chat.
Colin and Andrew, congratulations. Now, Andrew, you're the builder.
I'm the contractor, yeah, who's I've got this lovely thing to do up.
So, did you see the house before Colin bought it?
Not at all.
So you've just seen it for the first time today?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Wow!
I didn't even see the house before Colin bought it.
Colin, what were you thinking?
I bought it blind.
So, Colin, why have you bought this house? Is this an investment opportunity or is this just to keep you busy?
To give me something to pop round and see how it's coming along and watch the progress of it. Mm. And just to keep, because I'm a pensioner now, Lucy, and I don't have much to do. I used to be a bingo caller and I had plenty of work then, but I've got nothing now. No one wants me anymore.
So it's quiet for you, but this is going to keep you busy because
yes.
You've got lots to do here.
Yes.
Were you quite pleased with what you paid?
Yes. I worked out the figures and if I come out just a little bit in front, I shall be happy.
Colin did pay £60,000 over the top guide price for the property. But I agree, if he keeps an eye on his budget and sells the property on, there is great potential here.
How's it going to work as you walk in through the front door?
As you come through the front door, the wall to the right-hand side will stay. That will still keep the lounge there.
Yeah. What about this window area, this rather interesting crittle creation?
That's going to be coming out.
Right.
That's going to be coming out. We'll probably board across here.
Okay.
Okay. So keep this as a nice, large lounge.
Fantastic.
Kind of area.
So a big open plan
big
room
open
here.
Big open plan room there. Kitchen goes on basically on two walls here.
Yeah.
Okay, with a breakfast bar at the back.
Okay.
Okay, taking that back wall out as well.
Yeah.
Going into a nice, basically, dining area at the back there.
So fabulous. So kitchen, dining area.
Kitchen, dining area, patio doors in the back, going out onto the back.
Going out into the jungle.
The jungle. I think there's a garden on there somewhere.
Colin and Andrew have a 3-month timescale, which which sounds doable, given that they won't need to apply to the council for planning permission. Well, the outside definitely looks spruced up. Wow. The hallway is looking bright and new, complete with the original banister, and as for the kitchen that time forgot, very nice indeed. A clean, open plan look that's perfect for modern living. In fact, the whole ground floor has been brought bang up to date, and I love it. The lounge is now much bigger, but they've still managed to keep the best of the period features, and they've squeezed in a loo and a utility, and the kitchen diner opening out onto the garden is just fantastic. And talking of gardens, remember the old bramble-filled jungle? Now that's better, although you will have to go to the shops for your blackberries now. Upstairs, Andrew and Colin have been very clever. They've given the back bedroom an ensuite shower room, which is just what it needed. The family bathroom is looking swish, and the old master bedroom has been partitioned to give a double and an extra box room. Not enough, they've cleared out the cellar to create a really useful space down there. Colin must be chuffed to bits with what the builder Andrew has achieved here.
It's better than I imagined it to turn out. I didn't think it'd turn out anything as lovely as this. But that's all down to Andrew's thoughts and plans and everything. And he's, I've got 100% confidence in him. So I just give him the keys and he just lets me know what it's going to cost and that's it.
Andrew has played a blinder, and the changes he's made to the layout downstairs work a treat.
The front room, we had that wall right across the middle of it with the little windows serving hatch or whatever it was before. So basically you want to extend that area, take the wall out, move the wall further back. The only problem, the hard bit, was actually trying to keep the old features and the old coving. Couldn't find the same kind of coving anywhere, so we had to actually build our own coving, make our own coving, which took a bit of time. But yeah, I think it turned out right in the end.
Another job delayed Andrew's start here, hence the slight overrun on the schedule. But what about their £30,000 to £35,000 budget?
Budget in the end was about £43,000, Andrew, £42,000, something like that.
It was no, a little bit less than that, probably about 37, I think.
You charged me 41.
No, I didn't.
You dog.
No, I didn't.